It's like down there.
That's so weird.
It's so dumb because if I have to type, it's like
so weird. It's so dumb. My God.
Hi, Katie.
So happy to see your faces. Oh, what a day. Laura, hi.
Long time no see.
Long time no see, for real. So happy you're here.
Awesome. Yes, it's good to be back. And Ellie's here too.
Ellie, oh my God. Cuteness. I love you. Who's this? Is this little friend?
Yes. That's baby.
Baby. Baby. Hi, Kim. Hi. Hi, Laura. Hey, Rachel.
Hi, Tanya.
How are you? Hi.
Are you back from Teasdale?
For now I am.
Mm-hmm.
But I'm probably going 2 days on this weekend. So
good. Nice.
Yeah.
How I feel about the desert. Everyone's like, oh, you're back from Moab. I'm like, until I go back.
It's only temporary.
Do I live in Kim's house? I don't know. Maybe.
Where's the peeps? Laura, did you see there's a playlist in the group chat if you want it? In the title.
Oh, okay.
If you want to use it. Thanks. Tanya, I sent one to you.
Got it.
Yeah. They're so bright.
She's like stirring.
Usual. She's not in her dark.
I'm over to do yoga at Rachel's and she's trying to melt me because I am a witch and a vampire. So.
Hi, Scott Frost and Susie Q.
Hey, Katie.
Like, I have a mouth. I don't
know. Love you guys all. Where's Rhea? Is she with you?
So- oh, I can. She's in the other room. I've got a little Winsty, though.
A little Winsty? You always got somebody there. Little Winsty. Hi, Kitty.
Rhea's too much of a puppy still. Like,
yeah,
she just wants
I know.
To-
I know what you mean. Hopefully. Hi, Wendy.
Hi. Kennedy is joining us too.
Kennedy is?
Yeah.
Gracing us.
Hey, Laura.
Hi. Hi, Scott. Good to see you.
Hi, Wendy.
Like we got the gang back.
Hey. Hi, Em. Thanks for coming again. I love when we start to get like new people
on screen.
Not that I don't love all the people, but
a vampire and a
butter.
Basically, we prefer the new people. So.
Can you see this?
Yeah, Wendy, we're used to you. So.
That was a double bird.
Yeah.
Do you like it?
Apparently Bartholomew is taking over my yoga mat. So,
hey, I saw a quick little YouTube video of a girl that made a scary cat head to put on near her yoga mat so her cat wouldn't come on, and it worked, and her cat was super scared.
Cats. Funny creatures they are.
They are funny.
Yeah. One time Katie came over to my house, and she looked at my cat, Tucker. This was a while ago. And she was like, I don't understand cats.
No, I said, I don't know how to be around. I don't know how to be around cats.
She just got really awkward all of a sudden. And she was like, I don't understand them.
Dogs are like,
come up to you?
Yeah. Dogs, they know me. I know them. We just vibe. But me and cats.
Look at Em's cat. That's so cute.
Oh, that is a cute cat.
That is cute.
I like that kind of cat.
So like Kim's cats are just them keeping me up all night long, just having a party.
Cats, for reals. Tanya, get out of here.
I'm not even gonna comment.
Tanya.
What?
We love you. We love you, Tanya.
Tanya's naughty. She's just naughty all the time. So
So untrue.
Naughty. Let's ask Rachel. Rachel, is that true, what I just said?
I'm not saying anything.
That means I'm that's in. A yes.
No, not at all. Yes.
I'm in.
Not stepping in that one.
Yeah. Come say
that's
hi.
Fair. That's fair.
See how my night goes.
The cutest.
Social. Come down
here. I love Scott Frost. That's all I'm saying. Okay.
I make Infinity come in and say hi. She get over hi. Her. Shyness.
Get over your shyness, Kennedy.
Jeez.
We're just kidding. Wait, shy.
Need some sunglasses.
I'll see myself out.
Okay, Tanya and Rachel, put on your sunglasses. Everybody else.
What is she doing to me?
Okay.
The only sun I've seen all day.
I know. Is the sun even shining out there? I don't feel like it is where I'm at.
It is here.
In a basement apartment.
It is in the basement. Okay. Muting you guys. Should we start yoga? Should we do yoga?
Yeah.
Okay. Mute all. Play your music. Let your dogs bark. Whatever. In your own space. And feel free to turn off your video if that is more comfortable. Whatever works best. And then... let's just go ahead and get started. So find a comfortable seat on your yoga mat. And you can take a moment if you want to, just kind of stretch a little bit. Maybe roll your shoulders around, roll your head around. So any little movements that feel good. And then as you're ready, just find stillness and settle in. So close your eyes, sit up nice and tall, lengthen your spine, lengthen the back of your neck, and then soften your face, relax your shoulders. You can rest your hands in your lap, bring your hands to your heart, or one hand to your heart space, one hand to your belly. So just take this time to really arrive here on your mat, in your own body, just listening to your breath, feeling your breath, maybe noticing sounds, smells, sensations, thoughts. And just arriving more fully in this present moment. Perhaps notice what you've brought with you from your day today. So any emotions that might be just kind of sitting inside of you, maybe lack of emotion even. Notice energetically how you feel. Notice any physical sensations that are there. What feels comfortable to you in your seat? What feels uncomfortable to you? And then let's just drop into our practice with three great big deep breaths. So next time you inhale, fill up as big as you can. Hold at the very, very top in fullness. When you think you're full, sip in just that little bit more. And then exhale, big open mouth sigh. Do that two more times. So inhale, fill up. Hold at the top and take a moment to just feel this breath, this prana, this life force energy inside of your body, all the little spaces. And when you're ready, big sigh, let it go. Ha. One more time. So biggest inhale you've taken all day. Hold at the top. And then any stress, anxiety, anything you're holding that you no longer want, you no longer need, imagine just breathing it all out. So big, huge exhale. And just let it go, soften, relax a little bit more. And then seal your lips and start to bring in ujjayi breath. So in and out through your nose, gentle constriction in the back of your throat. So start to create that whisper noise, that oceanic sound with your breath.
And you can take as long as you want, just sitting, breathing, observing. When you feel ready to add some movement, maybe you start from your seat with just some seated cat-cows or some circles through your torso. But eventually we will all find our way onto hands and knees and then start to move intuitively from there. So no rush, please take your time. Eventually tabletop position and just explore your body. So as you explore, what can you notice? What feels a little bit tight or stiff or sore or tender? And then what feels really good, maybe really strong or more open than usual? So just kind of taking an inventory of how your physical body feels. And then at the same time, can you feel your breath moving through you? So that life force energy flowing in and out. Imagine that each time you breathe in, you can fill up all the spaces inside of your body, create even more space than there was before. And then each time you exhale, let it go and find emptiness, find stillness. So at the bottom of each exhalation, maybe even pause for a moment and feel into that stillness. Spaces between the breath. Give yourself about 5 more rounds, just exploring intuitively in an unstructured way. Maybe even close your eyes. And then after your 5 more rounds, or just whenever you feel ready, downward facing dog will be our eventual destination. So you can get there in your own time and even get there in your own way. Once you're back in your down dog, explore from there. So pedal out your heels, shift your weight from side to side, shake your head yes or no. So rather than just popping up into your down dog and then just hanging out, waiting for the next pose to come, be in your downward facing dog and see what you can find, see what you can discover. So what would happen if you take your feet out a little wider? What would happen if you widen your stance just a little bit? Maybe you wanna bring your feet in a little bit closer, see how that feels. So everything is constantly changing, including us and our bodies. So what do you feel today in your down dog? Is there any way you can be a little more efficient in your body? Maybe use your breath a little bit more to support you. Can you find that connection to center? So like I always say, that invisible rope, it's attached to your belly button. Feel it pull up towards the sky and then tug slightly back. So you've really got that length from your fingertips, through your spine, through your side bodies, all the way up into your sit bones. Take one more inhale into your down dog. And then with your exhale, look to the top of your mat, step, tiptoe, or hop forward fold. Pause here for just a moment. You can take ragdoll if you want. You can bring your hands behind your head and interlace your fingers if you'd like. So give yourself just a moment to be in your fold and to feel it. Notice where you're holding the weight in your feet. Make sure you're not rocking back into your heels and locking out your knees. So weight is slightly forward. Lift your butt, lift your sit bones towards the sky. Imagine again that invisible rope pulling up on your belly button. Crown of your head towards the ground. Take one more breath. With your next inhale, halfway lift, spinal extension. So lengthen up. Exhale, refold. Do that just one more time. Inhale, halfway up. Crown of your head reaches forward. Tops of thighs press back. Sit bones broaden. Exhale, fold. And then this time, come through your halfway lift and continue to rise. So reverse swan dive. Inhale, stretch your arms to the sky. Exhale, draw your hands into your heart. Let's flow with breath for a moment. Inhale, high mountain. Exhale, heart leads, slowly dive all the way down, forward fold. With your inhalation, spinal extension, lengthen. And with your exhalation, release, let it go. From the press of your feet, lead with your heart, rise up. Inhale, take your arms to the sky, big full body stretch. Exhale, hands to your heart center. Again, like that, inhale, high mountain. Exhale, follow your breath, ride your breath down, forward fold, Uttanasana. With your inhale, Ardha Uttanasana, lengthen it out. Exhale, let it go, refold. So find emptiness, then press into your feet, lead with your heart, rise. Inhale, take your arms to the sky, maybe take your gaze up. Exhale, hands to heart center, connect back with you. All right, this time, inhale, stretch your arms up. And as you exhale, cactus your arms and sit back into a chair pose. So Utkatasana, fierce pose, weight is in your heels, your butt reaches back, and then think of pressing your arms back and your chest forward. Now notice what happened to your belly. If your belly just let go, draw navel to spine and find that little tone, that little support in your low abdominals. It's supporting your low back. See if you can sit a little bit lower, press your arms back, your chest forward. Take one more breath here. Now listen, the only thing that you're gonna do is hinge at your hips. So everything stays the same, hinge at your hips, bring your spine parallel to the ground. So now your butt is sticking out behind you, crown of your head is reaching forward. Imagine you're trying to press your arms up towards the ceiling as you press your chest towards the ground. See if you can really squeeze through your shoulder blades. Now stay where you're at or start to straighten your legs by lifting your sit bones up and pressing the tops of your thighs back. Don't let your spine round. Wherever you're at, give me one more big deep breath, super long through your spine. End of your exhale, let it go, forward fold. Halfway lift, breathe in. Exhale, fold. Plant your hands this time, step back to plank. So top of a push-up, you're welcome to come to your knees. Take a moment. Just find your strength. So press into your hands, draw your belly button in and up, breathe into your back body. See if you can start to rock just very slightly forward and back. So nothing is changing in the position of your body. You're just rocking it forward, rocking it back, transferring your weight. Next time you inhale, find that little rock forward, start on your tippy toes. And then see if you can keep that, exhale, lower halfway down. Don't let your belly drop, don't let your shoulders roll forward. Inhale, press back up, high plank. Do that one more time. Exhale, little rock forward, lower halfway. You can come to your knees if you need to. Inhale, press back up. This time, as slow as you can go, exhale all the way down. All right, let's take a Spider-Man Cobra. So hands out nice and wide. Lift to your fingertips, elbows face the sky, then lift your chest up, breathe in. Exhale, twist to your right, left shoulder dips down. Inhale, back to center, heart lifts, belly tones. Exhale, twist to the left, right shoulder dips. Inhale, back to center, lift your heart, gaze forward. Exhale, let it go. Choose one more backbend variation, your choice, your expression. So baby cobra, full cobra, up dog, sphinx. And then when you're ready, all the way back, downward facing dog. All right, my friends, from your down dog, next inhale, take your right leg to the sky. So pause here for just a moment. Inner thighs face each other. Press up through your right foot. You can flex, point, or floint your right foot, but try to get your right leg really straight, strong, and powerful. Maybe you need to bend your left knee a little bit more in order to straighten your right leg. So see if bending your left knee will allow you to find more length through your right leg. Maybe lift your left sit bone, your left butt cheek higher, and then see if you can stretch your right leg back even further. Take one more big inhale, press down into your hands, lengthen your spine. Exhale, right knee to your nose. So curl in, hollow out your belly. Stay here, take a big inhalation and see if you can lift your right shin a little bit higher. Exhale, softly step your right foot to the top of your yoga mat. And then we're gonna start today just with a low lunge, back knee on the ground. So bring your back knee down. And if you need extra cushion, you're welcome to use a blanket, a pillow, or even double your mat up underneath that back knee. Hands come up to your front thigh. So walk your front foot forward just a little tiny bit, and then start to lean forward like you want to sit your right butt cheek on your right heel. At the same time, press down through your right heel and think of pulling your heel back and up towards your right butt cheek. So you want to create what's called muscle energy in your legs. Make sure your left hip is not turning out to the left, you're directing it forward. Tone your belly, lift your heart, reach through your fingertips, arms to the sky. Breathe here. You can stay here, or final option, bring your right forearm across your low back, so right forearm across low back, and then think of pressing your forearm forward and even tractioning down. Lift your heart up, start to reach your left fingertips further back. Breathe all the way down into the front of your left hip. Two more rounds, wherever you're at, your fullest expression, right butt cheek towards your right heel, heart lifted, belly toned. If you have your right arm behind you, next inhale, right arm to the sky, reach. Exhale, bring your hands to the ground, and then go ahead, tuck your back toes under, lift your back knee up. We're gonna step our back foot forward just a foot or so for pyramid pose. So for pyramid today, feet on two railroad tracks, all 10 toes face directly forward, both feet flat on the ground. Inhale to a halfway lift and bring your hands to your hips. Then as you exhale, come all the way up to stand. So now you're standing, right foot forward, left foot in back. You can take a moment, square off your hips if they're not already. So gaze down and your hands should be directly across from one another. Adjust if necessary. Next time you breathe in, arms to the sky. And then exhale, cactus your arms, lift your heart, little baby back bend. Inhale, reach your arms back up, realign your spine. Exhale, bring your hands behind you and interlace your fingers. Roll your shoulders back and down, squeeze shoulder blades towards your spine. So see if you can possibly start to reach your hands back. And then think of reaching your right butt cheek back, hinge at your hips, lead with your heart, slowly dive forward, 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 and then down. See if you can lift your knuckles towards the sky. If that's too much, hands can rest on your low back, or you're welcome to bring your hands to your hips instead. Forehead towards your right shin, right sit bone pulls up, the top of your right thigh presses back. Each time you exhale, use your core strength. So draw your belly button in and up from that place. See if you can dive deeper, fold further. You've got just two more rounds. Good job, my friends. Keep your fingers interlaced if you can. If you need to let it go, no big deal. Think of standing splits with your fingers interlaced behind your back. So as you're ready, root into your right foot. Left leg floats up. We're not going to hold it for very long, but just play with it. Use your center, your core to help you find balance, to stabilize. Take one more inhale with your fingers interlaced. Exhale, release your clasp, fingertips to the ground. So you're in regular standing splits, everybody. Draw navel to spine. That invisible rope is pulling up on your belly button. Left leg high, spread through your left toes. Relax your neck. If you'd like, you can wrap your right arm behind your right leg. Use that as leverage. So press arm into leg, leg back into arm. Forehead moves a little closer to your shin. Make sure wherever you're at, you're breathing big, deep breaths. Give me just two more rounds. Nice job. End of your second exhale. Set your left foot down next to right at the top of your yoga mat. Forward fold. You can give your right leg a little shake out. All right. Inhale to a halfway lift position. Lengthen. Exhale, fold, plant your hand, step back to plank. One more time, we've got two push-ups. So inhale, find your little rock forward. Exhale, lower just halfway. Don't let your belly drop. Inhale, press back up, high plank. One more time, exhale, halfway down. Strong arms, strong belly, even strong legs. Inhale, press up. And then exhale, slow as you can go all the way to your belly. Spider-Man Cobra again. We're gonna go somewhere different. So come up to your Spider-Man Cobra. You're on your fingertips, your chest is lifted, your elbows face the sky, and then bend your right knee. So left leg stays straight, right knee bends. Press into your right set of fingertips, roll onto the outside of your left hip. Reach your right toes towards the ground behind you, and then kind of dip your left shoulder down so you feel that nice stretch there. Breathe into it. If you want to take it deeper, right toes reach up towards your left hand a little bit further. Take one more breath, one more round, one more breath, one more round, and then slowly unwind, switch to the other side. So left knee will bend, press into your left fingertips, roll onto the outside of your right hip. Think of reaching your left toes towards the ground and then up towards your right hand. Let your right shoulder kind of dip down. Breathe. End of your next exhalation. Let it go. Unwind. And again, you choose one more back bend. So anywhere you want to take it can be what you did before, something totally different. You can take an extra breath or two. When you're ready, downward facing dog. All right, reconnect to your Ujjayi breath. So if you've lost track, fire it up again. Find that strength and power behind your breath. Next inhale, left leg to the sky. So hips square, inner thighs face each other. Notice your right leg, so the one that's on the ground. Does it feel lazy? Are you sinking into your right hip? Think of hugging in with your right inner thigh, even lifting up to the ball of your right foot, and then see if you can reach your right butt cheek higher. Now see if you can lengthen your left leg more, make it straighter, stronger, more powerful. Press into your hands, lengthen through your side bodies, lengthen underneath your armpits. One more big inhale. Exhale, left knee to your nose, so curl in. Your shoulders should be over your wrists now. Stay here as you breathe in, press the ground away. Exhale softly, left foot steps through, and then bring your back knee down ever so gently. If you need that extra cushion, grab it, put it underneath your back knee, and then hands up to your front thigh. Walk your front foot forward just a little bit, an inch or so, and then think left butt cheek towards your left heel. Don't let your right hip turn out to the right. Keep directing it straight forward. And then with your left foot, press down and think of pulling back. Tone your low abdominals, lift your heart, reach up. Maybe slightly gaze up. Perfect place to stay. Stay here if you want. Final option, left forearm across your low back. Press your forearm forward and traction it down. Lift your heart up, so chest towards your chin, and then start to move your throat back. Reach your right fingertips back and feel that stretch all the way down into the front of your right hip. See if you can send your breath there. Let your left butt cheek move closer to your left heel, heart higher. Two more rounds. Good job, my friends. If you have your left arm behind your back with your next inhale, left arm to the sky. And then everybody exhale, hands to the ground. Tuck your back toes, lift your back knee, pyramid pose stance. So back foot steps forward. For today's pyramid, feet on two train tracks, all 10 toes face forward, both feet flat on the ground. Inhale to a halfway lift, bring your hands to your hips. And then as you exhale, unhinge, come all the way up to stand. So you can take a moment, make sure your hips are square, adjust if you need to. And then next inhalation, arms reach up. Exhale, little baby back bend. So cactus your arms, bottom tips of shoulder blades squeeze. This should feel like a little bit of a balance challenge. Inhale, arms re-extend, realign your spine. And then exhale, hands behind your back, interlace your fingers. Roll your shoulders back and down. Shoulder blades hug your spine. And if you can, start to reach your hands away from your body back behind you. Now think of reaching your left butt cheek back, sticking your left butt cheek out behind you as you hinge at your hips. Lead with your heart. Slow dive forward and then eventually down, forehead towards your shin. So think belly towards the top of your thigh, ribs towards your knee, and then think of reaching your heart past your knee. So you're really trying to lengthen, and then you can relax your neck. Use your breath. So each exhale, empty all the way out, draw navel to spine. From that place, dive deeper, fold further. You've got about two more rounds. Maybe lift your knuckles higher. If it's too much, you can release your clasp at any time. Nice work, you guys. So again, we're moving into that pose. It's called, I think, toppling tree. It's just like standing splits, but you've got your hands clasped behind you. So start to root into your left foot, gaze slightly forward, stay connected to your center, and float your right leg up. Reach it as high as you can. Give me just one or two breaths with your fingers interlaced. Spread your toes, woo, and when you cannot hold on anymore, bring your fingers to the ground. Standing splits. And if you fell out of it, that's okay too. That's why we're here. That's why we're practicing. Be kind to yourself. Be compassionate. All right. So option to take your left arm behind your leg. Option to just hang out, but work the pose with your breath. Lift through your belly button. Lift through your center. Let your face be soft. Let your neck relax. See if you can find any more length, any more space. Breathe into it. One more inhale. Reach, reach, reach. Lengthen, lengthen, lengthen. Exhale, forward fold. Set your right foot down. You can give your left leg again that little shake out if it feels good. All right, set your left foot back on the ground. Inhale, halfway lift. So realigning. And then exhale, listen, plant your hands. You can either step back to your plank, or if you want to play with crow for just a moment, now is your time. So walk your knees up on your triceps, gaze slightly forward. Really think of lifting through your waistline. Again, that invisible rope is tugging up on your belly button. What do you know? See if you can lift your feet up. Maybe get your big toes to touch. Breathe into your back body. When you've had enough of your crow, either step or if you want to, play with a jump back to chaturanga with bent elbows. Move through a vinyasa. And then just for a moment, either child's pose or down dog, it's up to you. So if you took crow pose and you want to give your wrists a little break, child's pose is probably a good option. If you skipped crow and you want to go back to down dog and stretch for a moment, go for it. Whatever works for you, take about two or three breaths, just reconnecting. And even think of recommitting to your practice, recommitting to those strong, vibrant breaths. All right, my friends, and we'll meet on our hands and our knees, tabletop position. Okie dokie. So make sure your fingers are spreading really wide. Press down through your hands like you're trying to push the ground away. So you should feel strength in your arms and your shoulders. Draw your belly button in and up. Lengthen through the back of your neck. Next time you breathe in, right arm forward, left leg back. Try not to change the position of your spine as you reach forward and back. So that's half the challenge, is just keeping your spine in that neutral position as you reach. Actively reach through your fingers, spread your fingers, and then press with your back foot. Hips should be square. Take one more inhale, pull yourself apart. Exhale, elbow to knee underneath you. Curl in, hollow out. Inhale, re-extend, lengthen. Like you're moving in slow-mo. Exhale, elbow to knee. Empty all the way out, round even through your mid-back. Inhale, lengthen. Press with your foot, reach through your fingertips. Last one, elbow to knee. Curl in, hollow out your belly. This time, inhale, re-extend. And then as you exhale, move towards your bow variation. So left knee bends, left heel towards your butt cheek, right arm reaches back. Lift your heart and gaze forward. If it is available to you, grab hold of your foot or your ankle, and then kick foot into hand, pull hand back into foot, hug in with your inner thighs. Tone through your low belly. Breathe into your low belly. Two more breaths. Nice work, friends. End of your next exhale, release. Inhale to re-extend, so neutralize your spine. And then exhale, set just your right hand down. Pivot on your right knee so your right foot comes to the outside of your mat. Left arm to the sky, open up into your modified side plank. So squeeze your outer right butt cheek and press your hips forward towards the left side of your mat. Take your left arm forward towards the top edge of your mat. So left side body nice and long. Stay here if you want, or final option, bend your left knee, reach back, grab hold of your left foot. Kick foot into hand, pull hand back into foot. See if you can turn your heart to look up at the sky. Give me two or three more rounds, fullest expression. Tone your low abdominals, breathe into your front body. Feel your back muscles squeeze around your spine. See if you can create a little more space. Last breath, end of your exhale, release, unwind, come back to hands and knees, and then we'll take it back to downward facing dog. Inhale from your down dog, right leg high. Exhale, bend your right knee, open your right hip. You can stay here or option to flip your dog. Wild thing, right? Tiptoes come down behind you. Right arm lifts and reaches forward. Heart opens towards the sky. Back muscles squeeze around your spine. So you're starting to feel your back muscles strengthen. They're getting stronger as we speak. Feel them support you here. One more round. End of your exhale. We'll come back, everybody, meet in your three-legged down dog, right leg extended high. Breathe in to lengthen, and then exhale, right foot to the top of your mat, as soft as possible. This time, crescent lunge, take it all the way up. So front knee over your front ankle, high on the ball of your back foot. Think of pulling your right hip back, your left hip forward, tone through your belly, lift through your heart, breathe. Soften your face. Unclench your jaw. One more inhale. Exhale, bring your hands down to your front thigh and lean forward just a little bit. So you've got a nice diagonal line from the top of your head back to your left heel. Really push your hands into your thigh. And as you do that, draw your belly button back towards your spine. Breathe into your low back. So try to keep that connection, this strong band around your middle. As you're ready, we're going to float our back foot up, warrior three variation. So hips are still square, inner thighs still face each other. Stay here with your hands on your front thigh or right arm reaches forward. So right arm forward, left leg back. Just like we did on the ground a moment ago, stay here or take one more inhale with me. And as you exhale, right elbow to your left knee, curl in, round your spine. Inhale, re-extend. So you've already done this, now you're just balancing on one foot. Exhale, elbow to knee, slow motion. Draw your belly button in and up, inhale, lengthen. This is your last one. Exhale, slowly with control, elbow to knee. Inhale, re-extend. And exhale, everybody, forward fold. So hands to the ground, left foot steps down. Give your right leg a little shake out. Lift up halfway with your next in-breath, lengthen. Exhale, plant your hands, step back to plank. You can move through a vinyasa or you can skip it. Meet back in down dog, or give yourself a child's pose, about two or three breaths. So again, reconnect, recommit, become present. Arrive here over and over again to this moment in time, to this moment in your body, to this moment with your breath. Everybody transition to a tabletop. So wherever you're at, find your way to tabletop, hands on the ground, fingers spread wide, tone your belly, lengthen the back of your neck. Push your hands down so you feel the strength in your arms. You're not just sinking into your elbows or your wrists. As you're ready, so with that nice neutral spine, left arm forward, right leg back this time, spinal balance. So reach, 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 pull yourself in two directions. Notice if you let go through your belly, draw your belly button in and up. Notice if you opened your right hip, hip should be nice and square. So this is just like our Warrior Three variation that we just came out of and we're gonna go back into on this side. So feel it, start to create muscle memory. Feel the strength in your core here. Take one more big inhale, exhale, elbow to knee, slow motion. Inhale, re-extend, lengthen. See if you can reach even further, stretch, exhale, elbow to knee. Inhale, re-extend. And this is your last one, like you're moving through molasses. Exhale, elbow to knee, curl in. Inhale, lengthen. And then exhale, half bow variation. So left arm reaches back, right knee bends, heel to your glutes. Lift your heart. If it's available to you, grab hold of your foot or your ankle. Kick foot into hand, pull hand back into foot. Hug in with your inner thighs. Let your heart open. Let your shoulders open. Tone your belly to support your low back. Find that connection to center. Take two more breaths. Fullest expression. And good job. End of your next exhale. Release. Reach forward and back. Realign. Breathe in. Exhale. Just your left hand down. Pivot on your left knee. Right arm to the sky for your modified side plank. So take just a moment here, make sure your butt's not sticking out behind you. So try to get all the flexion out of the front of your hips, all the bend out of the front of your hips. And then take your right arm forward, reaching past the top edge of your mat. Lots of length, stay here if you want, or bend your right knee, reach back, grab hold. See if you can take your gaze up and then allow your heart to follow. Kick foot into hand, pull hand back into foot, and keep spreading your toes. Give me about two more breaths, fullest expression. Get everything you can out of it. What you put in is what you'll get out. End of your next exhale, release, unwind, back to hands and knees, and then back to downward facing dog. Inhale, left leg to the sky. Exhale, open your left hip, bend your left knee. So squeeze your outer left butt cheek, stack left hip on top of right. Perfect place to stay, or flip it over. Left toes come down behind you. Left arm reaches forward, heart lifts, hips lift. Feel the strength in your back body. Those back muscles hugging around your spine, supporting your spine. So take care of yourself in each pose by figuring out how to engage, how to support yourself. One last breath. End of your exhale, come back, three-legged down dog. Everybody, big inhale to lengthen. Soft as you can, slowly exhale, your left foot steps through. This time, crescent lunge, high lunge. Take a moment, find the stability in your legs, settle in. Left hip pulls slightly back, right hip pulls slightly forward, inner thighs squeeze, low abdominals tone, chest lifts. Soften your face and breathe. Take one more inhale and exhale, hands to your front thigh, lean forward a little bit, so find that diagonal line. Draw your belly button in and up towards your spine. So as you do that, you should feel a support right in your middle. Right at your center, all the way around your body, almost like a corset. You want to keep that. Left foot roots down and right leg floats. Warrior Three variation. You're almost there, you guys. Stick with me. Press with your back foot. Engage your core, lengthen through your spine, stay here, or take your left arm forward, asymmetrical warrior three. Reach forward and back, one more inhale. You're coming with me, exhale, elbow to knee, curl in slow motion. Inhale, re-extend, lengthen out. And again, exhale, elbow to knee. Move with intention, move with control. Inhale, re-extend, this is your last one. Exhale, elbow to knee. Draw your belly button in and up around your spine. Inhale, lengthen. And then everybody exhale, forward fold, let it go. Give your left leg a little shake out. Halfway lift, breathe in. Exhale, plant your hands, step back to plank. Move through your vinyasa or skip it. And again, meet in a child's pose. So this time, everybody, child's pose. And just take some time to rest, to relax, to give in. And I will, you made it, you guys, to the restore portion of class. So good job. I will pass the baton to Kimberly. Thank you and good work.
Awesome job, everybody. So hang out here in child's pose for like 5 to 7 more breaths. And if you want to adjust your knees a little bit or come into more of a puppy pose, if that's more comfortable for you, you can go ahead and continue to allow the body to ground and to rest and to settle here in child's pose. You can even take a sigh or two out your mouth. And so see if you can let go of any efforting in the body. And that will go for the rest of our practice today. Not a whole lot of effort, but rather an unwinding and a surrender. So take one more breath here. And then you're going to, as you're ready, come back up to your hands and your knees. And I'd like for you to take your hips in a big, broad circle going clockwise. See if you can really slow it down here and feel into each little nook and cranny. So you can lean into your stretch to your outer hip or your shoulder. And this really deliberate, mindful movement. Good. Now pause and just go the other direction. So if you went clockwise and go counterclockwise, the slower the better, everybody. A couple more breaths here. You're gonna make your way back up to center, back to neutral. Now, walk your hands over to the left side of your mat. So your hands are gonna be off of your yoga mat.
And then you're gonna pull the hips back and to the right. So you're in this kind of funky crescent-shaped child's pose or puppy pose. And stretch into the right ribs and between the ribs, those intercostal muscles, the shoulder, the outer hip, the low back. Really expand the breath along your right side body. And for the last couple of breaths, you begin inch your right fingertips up and over to the left, maybe another inch. Good, and back up, and we're gonna walk the hands over to the right side of the yoga mat. So walk the hands to the right. Take a breath here and then pull those hips back into the left. So really targeting now the left arm and ribs and side body. Good, really feel between the left ribs and the shoulder and down the waistline into the hip and lower back. Good, for the last couple of breaths, you begin inch the left hand, the left fingertips forward and over to the right. Last breath here. Good. And then make your way back to center. All right, so for this next pose, I'm gonna use a yoga bolster. I know that you may not have a bolster, but maybe you have a pillow or like a cushion from your couch or something you could grab real fast. You can do it also without, but just in case you have something handy, I'm gonna sit down on my right hip and take my legs into this kind of half pinwheel position. All right. So I'm sitting maybe, I don't know, just on this bottom half of my yoga mat with my lower body. And then I'm going to take my bolster, if I've got one, bolster or pillow, and extend it out toward the front top side of my yoga mat. I'm going to turn and face the bolster like this, lift up like a telescope, rib cage and chest. And then walk the hands forward and rest on my pillow or on the ground. Okay, so if you don't have a bolster, you can just crawl the hands forward and let your body rest here. This is one of my favorite restorative twists. And if you happen to have that pillow or cushion, it can be just a really comforting, nurturing pose, hugging around your bolster or pillow. And you can stay on the right ear, so right ear and right side of the head down. Or if you want to go a little bit deeper in your twist here, you could lift up and turn your head the other way. So you're looking to the right, coming onto your left ear. Okay, but find a place where you can really just ground and settle. Lots of breath moving along your spine. Notice where you're still holding on to resistance or tension in the body. See if you might release and let that go. Every exhale is an opportunity to cleanse a little bit, to release what's not serving you, stuff that's taking up space physically and energetically. I'd like you to stay here for 5, to 10 more breaths, continuing to soften, continuing to relax. Maybe really enjoying this particular pose, this moment in time where you don't have to do anything. Nothing to fix or remedy or accomplish or strive for. Good. And there is no rush whatsoever. When you feel ready, I'm going to bring the hands to the ground and just gently press on up to your upright position. Okay. Now, we are going to take that twist on the other side, but before we do, what you'll do is turn away from your bolster, if you're using it, the foot bolster or pillow, and bring that bolster right up against the base of your tailbone, sacrum, spine, and then just surrender on back. And certainly you can do this without your pillow, but if you've got something to place underneath you, it's a nice little heart opener. And you might consider bringing the soles of the feet together and letting the knees open out into Supta Baddha Konasana. So this really is a posture of surrender and non-attachment, allowing things to be exactly as they are. And sometimes we refer to this as goddess pose. So broad, wide, open heart, open palms, open belly, open hips, really receptive to the breath as it comes and as it goes. And this pose can also be a little bit vulnerable, so you might notice that showing up, some maybe feeling exposed or feeling maybe too open, and just maybe notice if there's some discomfort around that showing up and just observe that. We're going to stay here in this reclined heart opener for about 5 to 10 more breaths. Soften your shoulders, soften your jaw, relax your neck. Good. And if the soles of the feet are together in Baddha Konasana, you're going to gently stretch the legs out and reach your arms up and back alongside your ears. You're doing this big arch up and over your bolster or your pillow. Good. And then shift over towards your left side, and you'll bring your body back upright and set up for your twist on your left. So now you should be on your left hip and your legs bent in that half pinwheel position. And now you're turning towards your bolster or your pillow. Lengthen the spine like a telescope, lifting up. And then let's go ahead and walk the hands forward and recline on down into our twist. Supported twist. And again, you can be on the left side of your head, left ear, looking to the right, or you can go a little bit deeper by turning your head to your left, coming onto your right ear. Again, feel your breath moving along your spine, letting the body rest here, allowing the body to be at ease, supported by the ground, supported by your bolster. Let's stay here in this twist for 5 to 10 more deep breaths, allowing the body to soften and to relax, let go of tension and resistance through your exhale. Good. Take your time. There is no rush. As you feel ready, start to make your way gently back up. And you can put your pillow or your bolster to the side. And I'd like for you to roll down onto your backs and hug the knees in toward the chest. Good. Give it a little rock side to side, or you can circle the knees around. So feel for a gentle pressure massage around your lumbar spine, your sacrum, your low back, whatever feels good to you. Good, awesome, everybody. Now, bring the soles of your feet to the ground, and I'm gonna try to talk you through a little bit of a funky pose here, but what I'd like for you to do is move your right foot, specifically your right heel, over towards your left glute, okay? And you're gonna take your left hand and grab a hold of your right foot with your left hand, and let your right thigh and knee come down toward the floor. If you're unsure about what the hell I'm talking about, you can look up here. Okay, so you've got a hold of your right foot with your left hand, right leg is bent, right leg on the floor. Now, your left foot can stay on the ground, or you can pick up your left foot and let it rest on top of your right leg or right thigh. And if you like that gentle pressure, you could take the outer left foot to the right leg and open your left knee out to the left, almost like a funky figure four. Okay. So find a position of the legs that works, one of those options. And then the right arm is going to stretch up and back alongside the ear, and then just let your arm relax. So it might bend a little bit, it might fall up to the right a little bit, and that's fine. And then just let your head drop to your left. So you're moving your chin toward your left shoulder. And this is where you're gonna stay and hang out for several breaths. So you might be feeling this lots of different places. You might be feeling length along the right arm and the right side body and the right leg. You might be feeling a stretch in your right quad. You might be feeling a stretch in your left hip. And so not necessarily looking for anything in particular, but just allowing the breath to pass through, to move through. Good, five more deep breaths here. Notice where you can still soften, where you can still surrender a little bit more. Good, take one more cleansing breath here. And then just gently bring your right arm down. Uncross the left leg from the right. Let go of your right foot with your left hand. And stretch both legs out long to the floor. And reach the arms up and back alongside the ears. A little reset, whole body stretch. And then take your arms back down. Bring the soles of your feet back to the ground, okay? And we're gonna set that funky pose up on the other side. So you're gonna inch your left foot over toward your right glute, kind of underneath the right leg. Hold on to your left foot with your right hand and let your left knee and thigh come down toward the floor. Now from here, the right foot can stay where it is, it can stay on the ground, or you can pick up the right foot and kind of step on your left thigh, or rotate the leg open so you're pressing the outer right foot, resting that on top of your left leg and letting your right knee open out to the right. Okay, so kind of pick one of those options. The left arm stretches up and back alongside the ear and then just let your arm relax. So again, it might bend, it might goalpost, it might go out to the left a little bit, just let it do whatever it wants to do. And then from here, turn your head to your right. So you're moving your chin toward your right shoulder. So again, this side might feel different, but you might feel it in a different area. Along the left side body or the left quad or maybe the right hip. But let's just allow the body to rest here for several breaths, feeling whatever sensation, whatever opening, whatever might be moving through you. And certainly if it feels funky or if it feels stressed, any part of your body feels stressed by this, then back off a little bit. And we're gonna take about five more deep breaths here. Good. And as you're ready, we're going to take the left arm back down. Uncross the right leg from the left leg. Let go of the left foot with your right hand and stretch both legs out long to the floor. Reach and lengthen your arms up and back alongside the ears. Stretch, stretch, stretch. And exhale, let the arms come down. Good. So we are going to move towards Shavasana. And I'd like for you to do one of three things for Shavasana today. And certainly you can do whatever you want, but this is my suggestion. You either take your bolster or your pillow, slide it underneath your knees, so you have a little bit of support underneath the knees like this, or you scooch over to a couch or a chair, and you let your legs come up and over the chair like this. If you can kind of see what I'm doing, my legs are up and over the couch, but you can do this on a chair or, and the last option is to scooch over to a wall and take your legs up the wall. So coming into that full, what's called Viparita Karani, legs up the wall pose, and giving your legs a little bit of an elevated place here. So you can go ahead and kind of arrange and get situated here for our final relaxation corpse pose. And if you're patient here for just a moment, I think we are going to have a little bit of music from Kauai. But it might take just a moment. So meanwhile, just allowing your body to get a little bit more grounded and settled. Noticing the breath rising and falling.
Very little grows on jagged rock. Be ground, be crumbled, so wildflowers will come up where you are. You have been stony for too many years. Try something different. Surrender. Very little grows on jagged rock. Be ground. Be crumbled. So wildflowers will come up where you are.
You have been stony for too many years. Try something different. Surrender. That is Rumi, our beloved Rumi and our beloved Zoe. You can start to deepen your breath and move around a little bit here. As you're ready, shifting over to your side into a little fetal position for a few breaths. And making your way back up to your seat on your mat. No rush, whenever you're ready. We'll take the arms all the way up alongside the ears, reaching up tall. And then touching the palms together, gathering all of this beautiful energy that we've cultivated here, our practice, to your heart. Let's finish with one round of Om, and you're welcome to join in, or you can just listen. Take a full breath in.
Namaste. Yay. Oh my gosh. That was amazing. Everything.
So good. I was like in Shavasana. Were you waiting for a long time, Zoe?
No.
Oh,
okay. Yeah. Okay, good. I was like, oh shit. Okay. That was so nice.
That was so nice. Like, people around the planet are missing out. They need to come to this class.
Oh, reals.
Oh, no, they don't.
Tell everybody.
Special, and it's only for us.
That was wonderful.
I want everybody to put their animals up to the screen, and I want to take a picture of everybody's animals. Will you guys? Because it's funny. Okay, wait, let me see. Animals? Animals?
Yes.
Ours are sleeping.
Mine's kind of crazy.
You're crazy, Scott Frost.
No, maybe she's a pup.
Mara.
Yeah, King Kitty.
Okay. I was just thinking about everyone's animals during class. How I love that I get to see your animals since we do these Zooms.
We photoshopped.
The first time I haven't had an animal in like 25 years.
Guys, look at Zach. This is my dog. He's got an underbite. Look at his tooth.
Oh my God. He's amazing.
Oh my gosh, how old is that dog, Zoe?
Oh, he wanted more pets.
Oh,
nails today, so he wasn't my biggest fan. Oh. Earlier,
hate when I have to do that stuff to him. I just want him to love me so much.
Zach's my favorite.
Thank you so much.
Thank you, guys.
Thank you.
Thank you. I love you guys. Thanks, Zoe.
Thanks, Zoe.
Bye. Bye.